Anthony F. here, and today's topic is old technology. Is it worth it? Does it still have a place in today's world? Today's world, the cycle is so fast. It used to be about a 4-year cycle, and we complained about that. It used to be every 4 years you get a new hardware, you know, if you remember that. Nowadays, sadly, it's practically every 6 months it's time for a new piece of hardware. And that's crazy. That's insane. But it depends on the circumstance. Like, for instance, this. The incredible Pebble. Yes, this device actually worked. It did not have a problem or an issue. Everything worked. But guess what happened? They were bought and sold to Fitbit. So then they started having trouble with their servers. Well, it's not really trouble because clearly Fitbit said that they would not support any Pebble devices for long. So have fun while you can. And now every couple of weeks, the Pebble time, here is the Pebble time. The Pebble time would stop working, give an error or forget where it is. You have to reset it for it to work again. If it wasn't for that, I would still be using this device. It works. It tells the time. Excellent screen. Whether it's in the night or in the day or in the sun or in the shadows, the screen worked. And since this is the Pebble time, the color version with color here, it was even better. Does it look kind of corny? It looks kind of corny. Does it have a heart sensor? No. Nothing fancy. SIM card? No, not at all. Is it even a touchscreen? No, sir. But this watch lasts for days on one charge. Physical buttons did the job. It was incredible. But the fact that it keeps calling for the server every couple of weeks and it loses everything that you just set it up for makes it not worth it. And this is unfortunate because this was unplanned, you know. The consumer loses here. Supposedly, Fitbit said that they will give you a coupon for the Fitbit Ionic. And I signed up. Everybody signed up for it. And now, guess what happened? Another Fitbit version is coming out. What is it called? The Versa. Sounds like a car. The Fitbit Versa is cheaper, but it does not have the features that the Fitbit Ionic have. It's practically a Pebble device. I believe it at least has a heart monitor, which the Pebble time here doesn't have. If you want to be able to use Fitbit Pay, like the Fitbit Ionic does, for the Versa, you have to buy the next step up. It's like a half a step for about $30 more. Very interesting pricing model indeed. So here we have the first official Android Wear watch, the LG G Watch. Yes. So I immediately bought a band after I bought the LG G Watch because I'm a metal band kind of, you know, person. That's just what I like. The band that came with it, I did not like. Funny enough, I could stand this band on the Pebble, but I couldn't stand the band that was on the LG G Watch when it practically was the same kind of band, that rubber kind of resin feel. Wasn't a fan of it on the LG G Watch, I guess because the screen was bigger. Now this watch was built to last, technology-wise. Quad core is in here. Half a gig of RAM, 4 gigs of space for music and other apps. This was actually a almost future-proof device. Sadly, Android Wear 2.0, I believe, is not compatible with this. Even though it has a very big screen, this still works. Still works. So then, you may ask, why did I go with the Motorola 360, the first generation? Well, this is also metal. Number one. Wanted a metal watch. This is also round. even with the flat tire. So number two, I wanted a round watch. I didn't want the calculator watch. Remember the calculator watches in the 80s? Yeah, that was fun, but I really wanted a round watch that was also smart. And here we have it. This has the same features as the LG. As a matter of fact, the Motorola 360 first generation is actually slower than the LG watch. It has a TI processor in here. You know TI, Texas Instruments, one of the ones that make calculators. Well, used to make calculators. I don't know why Motorola put a slower processor in here. A single gigahertz processor instead of a quad core in here. This is a single core. I guess they figured this will work. And it does, in fact. Also, what else? This has a physical button, which lends to the watch. But what really made me want this, as you can see here, it has the heart monitor here, which I need a heart monitor. I'm getting old. I'm getting so old I can't even get to it. This thing is heavy. I think I used to that weight on this. It has a heart monitor right there. And it has wireless charging. And I don't mean hinky. Proprietary wireless charging. This has Qi wireless charging, like the phones do. That really is what sold it to me, because I really actually was looking at the Huawei watch, the first version, because it looked like a watch. This loses points because the band goes inside of the watch here, and therefore when it sits on your wrist, it sits on top of your wrist, which is kind of weird. It was unique. But what made me really want this is the wireless charging. This is also waterproof, as is the LG G watch. It's waterproof. I think the Pebble is too, I don't remember. But these are also very waterproof for swimming and water rides, things like that. The Huawei watch, the first one I believe was not. So that's also what made me want this. And once again, the wireless charging really sold it for me. Now here's a secret. None of these were purchased brand new. I did not buy any of these brand new. I bought these refurbished / used. Not from eBay, but from Amazon. Now why would I do that? Well, this is old technology. Do they have any of these brand new in a factory? Maybe. Highly doubtful. To get any of these things that are 2 to 3 years old, even a year old nowadays, you have to get it refurbished or used. And that also means the price is reduced. I'm okay with that, because I know what I need it for, and I know the technology. This is the same principle with buying used iPhones. Would you buy a used iPhone? Of course you would buy a used iPhone. It still works. Apple still supports at least third version back. So if you bought a used iPhone 6, you were in you were okay. iPhone 5, no, because the battery was just horrendous. But iPhone 6, iPhone 7, get it used, man. Lady, person, get it refurbished from Amazon. It's okay. Especially with the iPhone 10 not selling like they thought it would. Question is, how will the next iPhone models come? What will they look like? What technology will they have? That counts. And even though iPhone likes to make left turns, like now they're using USB-C, some technology, some legacy protocols will still be there, and you'll still be able to operate properly. So this is why I still buy old tech. It's like buying somebody's first album, you know? It lets you know what was really on their minds. Usually, the first album, is what they really intended. Sometimes the second album is what they really intended. But usually the first album is pure. Sometimes even classic, future-proof. And that's how I feel about these devices here. Classic and future-proof, except for the Pebble, since Fitbit bought it. But these two right here are future proof, still do as well, and they work. I don't need a watch with a SIM card in it. Whole idea is to get the phone out of my hand. So I just have a watch that tells the time and also gives my notifications from my phone. So why would I want a SIM card in my watch so I can have the watch do the phone? That defeats the purpose of wearables. It really does. But that's just my opinion. It's Anthony F. here, Everywhere LLC. Thanks for listening.